欢迎参加我们这次 iCloud Special Event 的 topic 是 Leaders on Leader We have on Leadership 所以我们这次呢有请到了三位 prominent panelists 我们马上就不要耽误立刻就准备开始开始之前的时候呢我们唱一首敬拜赞美的歌赞美我们的主耶稣基督
好我们请大家一起来好吗我们来赞美感谢你，谢谢你将今天的时间分别为圣，让我们在这里的不论是分享的，无论是参与的，都从你自己得着，照也奉给您祝福。这里的每一个成人，甚至是被你差遣成为社区的仆人领袖，谢谢。
荣耀归他，神羔羊。
在这里，愿意圣灵来浇灌在我们当中的每一个弟兄姐妹，愿一个服事的心的时候，亲爱主，你就差遣我们进入社区。主啊，因为你原是为服事人而来。主，我们来谢谢你，将我们今天的这样一个分享研讨，交托仰望在你的手中。再一次，愿我们这里的每一个弟兄姐妹和新来的朋友，亲爱圣灵，求你自己将这个智慧、启示和能力浇灌在我们当中，让服事的时候，因着有你的灵同在，大有能力。谢谢你，这样感谢祷告，奉主耶稣基督的圣名。
阿门。
来，我们再次欢迎彼此说，欢迎你来。
All right, welcome everybody to today's special seminar.
organized and hosted by the AgCloud Leadership Circle. And today's topic is leaders on leadership. I know for those of you that have participated in our leadership circle in the past, hopefully all of you remember one of the things we emphasized is everybody can be a leader in your own domain, in your own sphere of influence. And we encourage that. And today we have three very prominent and successful leaders with us. And they are going to share with us their own experiences and what paved the way for them to become successful leaders and what are some of the essential traits a leader should have. So before we start, I would just like to introduce our panelists. So we start with our first panelist, Lily May, and she's the mayor of Fremont. And we also have Jimmy Lee. He's the executive chairman of ISSI. He's also elder at CCIC San Jose. And he's also, of course, our mentor for what circle? Integrating Faith and Work, right? Yeah. All right, welcome. And last but not least, we have Jerry to the right. He is the executive chairman of U Channel and also the Bay Area Chinese chapter of Full Gospel Business. He's a recognized industry businessman, of course, and he's also the mentor and leader of our leadership circle. Thank you. All right, so without further ado, Jerry, why don't you take it away?
Okay. 我本来以为今天是讲中文，本来 think it's okay, I think this is our strength. So we're gonna mix 中文 and 英文。今天其实也有这个 iCloud 的，还有优势频道的录影啊。So okay, feel free, 中文英文 ，OK, this is a part of our strength, right? OK, actually I think we're being too formal. So 第一件事情 I'm gonna take off my shirt. 这是 meant to be 一个 dialogue style. 那我很谢谢两位co-panelists. 其实Mayor Lily May, I think it was a God's guidance, 因为我本来要送她一个邀请上礼拜，后来实在是忙不过来，结果在玉山碰见她。
Yes.
然后 you know, Mayor Lily is 高市长非常忙碌。But she happens to have the time at the lunchtime. Mm-hmm. And she's really tied her heart into develop and encourage leadership, particularly for cross church. So I know she's coming today. Actually, she's just on the road. There are some side cars. We welcome her again. She has a long list of her serving the track record and the history, including incumbent president of the
Asian School.
Yeah, school board, so she said at the state level. Okay, now obviously she has been Fremont school board for 6 years,
yes.
Right? And her current term will run through the end of 2020. So I'm sure that who are from Fremont here? We're going to count on your vote, okay, guys? 4 years later.
Thank you. Okay. I think we just pray for guidance. And
yes.
Pray for God's wisdom.
Yeah, actually, 我们今天 topic 应该叫做 servant on servanthood, instead of calling a leader a leadership, we're going to touch on that. Obviously, Elder Jimmy Lee, 我们的 co-mentor, 是我的学长 even though I know he looks younger than I, but yeah. So, 非常高兴 Jimmy 能够在我们当中。其实 actually, 他也我也很谢谢他。他有这个时间，他事实上今天中午有个 lunch， 后来把他 reschedule 掉。我们谢谢 Jimmy。Okay, so Sam, one example of the teamwork. Actually, 那个 Sam helped reach out， 然后国威help work with the team for the newsletter. It really takes a team. I think talk about leadership. The first thing is not individual but team. Where are you, 国威？He's probably busy 这个 helping everyone. 那还有那个 Sam， 我们谢谢还有后面的团队，我们谢谢他们。Okay, so I need to finish this for Mayor by 1:30, so I know that. Okay, so 第一个 question 哈，就是说要 share 一个 past experience about the change，
You know, you read Harvard Business Review on leadership, they will tell you, managers cope with complexity, and leaders cope with change. Mm-hmm. Okay, so leaders are often the change agent of where you serve. 所以有没有什么故事? Mayor and elder, share 一下，不管是在教会里的、跨教会的 community 的 policy 或者 business world， 有什么故事 where you were in that role to facilitate, enable, lead a change?
Sure, I'll start. I was going to say, 我先用中文的英文，我先照先说。 If you saw me earlier when I was singing, I can speak Chinese. 我是 ABC, 所以我在芝加哥生的，在美国长大的。 So I'm entirely ABC, and my Chinese 我勉强可以沟通的。但是我的上中文学校，it's been 30 some years. So 我的中文字 recognition is very bad. 我以前可以背看报纸的，but我没有常常用，所以就比较。 But when it comes to change, one of the questions you asked her later, I saw that, who's influencing you? When I was growing up, and she always was involved in schools, even though it has to be me. But she wanted me to know that she was cared about my education. And so, And when I was down to the PTA, when I was in PTA, I saw our PTA, even though our school is a lot of Chinese, but the parents attended for a lot of the PTA was very minimal, it was mostly Caucasian, when I was down PTA this time. And it was kind of unusual, because out of my daughter's yearbook, 20 kids, 15 are Chinese, and 3 were like Indian, and when I was maybe 1 Caucasian. And then 我就觉得很奇怪，我问家长，他们就跟我讲说，有时候他们 worry about your accent or you know other things，他们就说哦，我就觉得因为习惯的没有参加那个家长会。但是 I told them it's not about being perfect on speech, being a leader, but I think the kids really like to have 他们爸爸妈妈 to show interest in that. So during the time period I was on the PTA, it was. I'm not sure if I'm supposed to.
It's okay.
Okay. I'm like, okay, am I too quiet? It was a chance for me to see and get parents engaged and involved. And then I feel like, I don't know if I'm an agent of change or I get to be part of the change, but even for my city, growing up, you know, God puts you in places sometimes you don't know why you're there. And growing up, I could have said easily where I was in Pennsylvania, you wouldn't say, oh, do you know the Chinese, you could say the Chinese girl. And it'd be like, the? Because I was the only Chinese kid in my elementary school. And so it's very different versus now where I live in a city where it's a lot of Asian and diverse background people that are living in Fremont. But yet in the city council, or even on the school board when I ran, I had another school board member, Ivy Wu Wei, who was on the school board with me. And it was very interesting the first time I ran. They said, you know, somebody already represents you. And I said, you know, it's unusual because when they had 5 Caucasian board members, they never said, oh, there's somebody there already. And I told them that I didn't know I live in a crayon pack, and we can only have 1 yellow. So, I find that sometimes I try to deal with the sense of humor with that. And so being changed, but also being in a way that represents the community. And right now, as my leadership as a mayor, I'm really, really humbled to be the first woman mayor ever in 61 years and also the first minority. Part of it is bridging that relationship and having the confidence to recognize, as Sam said, anyone could be a leader. It doesn't mean you have to be elected, doesn't mean you have to be on any role, but it's how you interact with the community and how you can see not just going to make complaints, but also making yourself part of the solution.
Very good. Well, Well, thank the mayor for her short sharing. Lauren will come up. Elder Jimmy?
我可不可以 share 两个 change story?
Of course, of course.
那都很短。那第一个 change story, 我想就是跟教会的有关的。你知道我们是一个都是华人教会的。那大部分这个 members 都是 immigrants, from Taiwan, China, Hong Kong, right? 那对, second generation 就是 ABC 这个 miniature 就比较缺乏 那我们常常没有办法 retain the next generation 那我在 十多年前 因为在教会服事 有需要那个英文组有需要 我们有 我们教会有一个英文组 我说英文组是一个 adult, adult congregation 我们有差不多从四五个不同的地区 国家 的成员 譬如说 all kinds of Asian Americans from Singapore, Malaysia, Vietnam, you know, you name it, and we probably have it, okay? All Chinese, common language is English, but they all have different cultural background and all that. 那但是我们很 lacking 的一个部分就是去 reach out to the second generation. 那大家都有一个很 认为 反正孩子大了, 然后我们有一个 very good youth ministry, 就是青少年的 这个 ministry. Children ministry is very strong, 但是到了这个 college and young adult, young professional, 就非常困难, 没有办法留住孩子. 那大部分的人, 教会里面, 孩子长大以后就是他上大学以后, 他就 graduate from the church, from our church, okay? 那 adults 认为很自然的, 孩子大了以后, 他们就去 whatever churches or they want. 那事实上也有很多就 他们那个 faith 就 somehow in the process of lost, especially have very strong fellowship in the college days. But after they come back, it's hard to find a church to be plugged in. Right. 所以 我们在 就看到这个需要 我们就说 我想所有的 change 都是有一个需要嘛 There has to be a need before change, right? 那我们就 思想怎么样去 reach out to the second generation 所以我们就 emphasize 所有的 change process 就需要 跟弟兄姐妹先有些沟通 对不对? 我们说 Why we have to do this change? Why we think there's a need? Why we think God is guiding us in this direction? 所以 我们先跟把一批这个 college students 跟他们说我们希望跟你们见见面 谈一谈 开个会 然后就跟他们讲说 我们 really have heart to minister to you to be a blessing to you to affirm you the church going to be your church in the future we want to pass the baton to you because you grew up in this church and you were a member of this church and we have that close relationship and you know a lot of people in the church and we really want to learn how to reach out to you. 那我们也需要跟 adults 基本上讲说 我们希望有这样的一个 direction 然后 God's heart is for intergenerational ministry rather than just homogeneous or 我们只是 stay as an immigrant church. 我想这是一个 story 就是 step by step 我们做了这个已经是大概 六七年 至少七八年前的事情 I'm slowly making some progress 另外一个故事就是 公司里面的 change 那公司里面的 change 我们是 我简单提两个 change 一个是我们被 forced to change 因为我们公司那个时候一开始是 有些 products for PC for, 那个时候 Intel 出来的什么 386 啊什么需要 我就不讲那些 detail 没关系你们大概都是 这个 engineering 的 background Intel 是 它那个 process 因为很快就需要 cache memory 需要 cache controller 那我们公司就做这些东西 所以这个发展很快 我们把 cache memory high speed SRAM 这个每一年的市场 double, triple and 我们公司就 revenue profit 就这样子很快的 grow 上去 然后我们就上市了
也不知道怎么样，为什么就 很顺利这样，就we went public in 95 in Nasdaq。 那96年 Intel 开始就 integrate everything into the CPU， 所以 over a period of 18 months we lost 90% of our market。 所以叫什么，这个要 change， right？ 我们 C is coming， we try to make some changes， but the change in the marketplace was much faster than we even anticipated。 okay？ 那这样的一个 change， 我们当然是大家知道 you have to change， right？ Because your market is gone， 所以我们这是一个 change， we're forced to change。 那这个 change 当然是比较辛苦一点，因为怎么样 diversify， find a new market， 公司需要做一些 fundamental 的一些 structure 的调整，这些这是一个 change。 那后来我们就学会说 we have to move before the market changes。 所以第二次我们像我们现在公司是 50% 以上的这个 revenue come from automotive application， 它是一个 very stable slowly growing market， 但是非常 stable。 那这个我们就 proactively 就跟这个看到了这样子的，我们有 几个这个 high level 的这个 executive 看到有这个需要，那我们要这个分析了我们的 core competence，那我们的 culture， 我们的什么样的 market 跟我们 match 是最好，那我们就 proactively start a change。 那这个 change 要 slowly 跟几个人先都 convinced， 然后我们要跟稍微大一点的 group share 我们的 vision， share why we have to change， how we change， we bring in bring them in to change process。他们会提供一些意见，哪些有可能会出问题，哪些可以change faster。Anyway， so we 这个 change 我们大概 proactively 这样子做了差不多五六年，那这个公司 fundamental 的一个market and culture 或是我们对 customer engagement 的这些 philosophy， product design 的methodology 整个就 change。 但是 start with a direction， very clear objective， 然后 start from few people to maybe like 15-20 high level managers， and then bring in others come in， so it's step by step。 所以这是
谢谢。So if I kind of summarize， 刚才那个这个故事里面，you see the need， 看见需要 ，you articulate the vision， 将你的方向、目标、愿景解释清楚 ，you engage core group， 你的核心团队 ，and then you reach out to the entire team， 整个团队。我很短一个故事 ，move forward。在几年前，全福会我们希望能够在圣诞节的时候将圣诞节的音乐和上帝的爱进入社区。事实上，圣灵和牧师兄教会，我们那个时候还有这个基督之家。那 by the way， it's coming back tomorrow， I mean next year， not tomorrow， okay。 So 那我们那时候可是这跨过一个教会，我们希望能够连接众教会。那所以那个时候有牧主先锋教会、基督三家、基督五家、生命和灵粮堂、生命树灵粮堂，还有不同的机构。那我们就在 Flame Center 办了，同时我们将整个多的募款呢，就平均分给15-20个charity organization。所以 we took the financial responsibility and commit to donate every cent of surplus。For good cause. That's the true meaning of Christmas. 那我记得在那个 press conference 的时候，Pastor Tom Liu 刘同牧师啊，生命和灵粮堂的牧师，他说：“你如果明白教会之间的文化，这些教会在一起能够进入社区，他说这本身就是一个神迹 ，It's a miracle by itself. Okay, but Christmas is a season miracle.
所以我很高兴我们有这样一个机会，看见这样一个需要，然后 line up partner different churches and reach out。好，那下面两个，哎
，Jerry, let me just add a few quick notes.
Yeah.
So I mean, from my personal experience, driving change is usually two types, right? Either driving a changing process or driving a changing mindset. From my past experience, driving a changing mindset is the more difficult one. And the part that I want to add is, as leaders, when you're trying to drive change, you must role model the change first. You can't just expect others to change and you yourself stay the same. And also the other part is, it's a lot easier to drive a mindset change when you drive the change with a group of coworkers or core team members, right? When people see there's a group of people demonstrating that change, then more people will pile on and overcome that threshold to change.
Yeah, 我突然想到 Silicon Valley tech company 都喜欢讲什么 change the world, right? Change the world. I've also remembered reading a statement saying that everybody wants to change the world, but no one wants to change themselves. So, and 像 Sam 讲的 changing process, changing the way you tap onto the internet, it's not easy, but I think it's far harder to change the heart and change life, which will quickly come to the next point.就是呢as Christians, as servants, public servants, leadership, what's the role of the Christian faith in your, I'm going to combine two questions, in your serving, your calling, and in your life's purpose? What examples or stories, or how does it impact you?
Sure, I guess I'll go first. For myself, one of the challenges, having been on the school board before, is that the public's opinion there should be a separation of church and state. And certainly, as a Christian, when you're out there, when you go visit schools, I wasn't really allowed, you're not supposed to go in and indoctrinate or provide, you know, feedback to people that they would say, okay, it's like brainwashing my children. But one of the things that I reallyappreciated was the chance to spend time with children, because one of the things I love about children, if you go out to spend time with them, is that they are very open-minded and welcoming. And so when I have the opportunity to spend time with children, they refresh me and they keep me feeling young, at least, and just really that love that they have for the community as a whole. The other thing that I really feel grateful for is that when I first got on the school board, it was very bad times.And you can look at it two ways in terms of saying, okay, it's really bad times. It was the worst financial support for schools than the Great Depression. You had to make budget cuts. But then for myself, I was blessed enough to be able to, for example, give up my salary. So I volunteered and went from being a company middle executive type of role. And I donated all my stipends to the school district.And so when I was out there visiting the school, sometimes people would say, you know, it's because our meetings start as early as 4:30, and they would end maybe if I was lucky at 10, but often at 2 a.m. And so you're sitting there like crazy hours. I have my own two children, and it was hard at first, I'll be honest, even for my children. But you get a chance to be a role model, as you said, live your life. And so for my kids, I really appreciate my husband would bring my kids by sometimes the meetings and be like, good night, mommy, because they were little at that time.And it allowed people to humanize that role and to understand what I have to sacrifice to be serving. And then when people say, well, why would you do this? I don't understand. You know, especially kids of your career day, they look at my husband who's an attorney and they're like, oh, attorneys make a lot of money. So how much do you make? And I'm like, zero. And they're like, why would you do this job? But then it allows me the opportunity to talk about my Christianity and why I feel that.Because I've been given so many gifts or blessings from God that I am able to then share those with others. And so it, in its own way, allows me an opportunity to give testimony and to share with others in the community why it's important, how God has played such an important role in my life. I've been blessed, even on decisions when we talk about change. Many years ago, one of the hardest decisions to make for a school district is the leadership role. And at that time, we needed to go look for a superintendent.And I know that everyone has different opinions on how to go through the process and who to search for. And I was thinking there's five people on the school board and everyone has very strong will and strong opinions. And I was like, okay, we're not going to be able to agree. And there's some really polarized opinions, especially in the Bay Area. I would say I'm definitely one of the fewer, more, I would say, moderate slash conservative people. And so, you know, I was thinking, we're not going to agree. Who's going to find a leader that can please all of us? And so it was through a lot of prayers, because we went through about originally 250 resumes, down to 100 resumes, down to 50, down to 10, down to 5, and the final three. And there were some differences of opinions. And I kept saying, oh my goodness, how are we going to get the five of us to agree? And we were just so lucky in the end that the leader we were able to choose, all five of us loved. And it happened to be someone who was Christian, too. And so, you know, it was just amazing and fortunate that we were at the right place at the right time. But I think God has things in your plans that sometimes you can't predict. And when it comes to things like change, I've also shared with you jokingly that I was growing up, I was the only Chinese kid. But there are a lot of struggles with that, too. So I grew up in the period of the Vietnam War, you know, right after the Vietnam War. And being the only Asian person, you know, I've been stuffed in lockers, I've had mailbox in my house blown up, I've had my windows shot out and my tires slashed. And so it was a lot of stuff, you know, when you're a kid, you're like, wow. And when I tell children, they think that you must have grown up in the 50s, which I greatly appreciate, but I wasn't. But you know, it's how you handle that and how what type of resiliency. And that while I was a child, I didn't know why would I go through this stuff, because sometimes you're like, God doesn't love me, why am I doing getting this happening to me? But it allows me the understanding, the empathy, and the resilience that I need today for the things, some of the things that I deal with. And so I think that, you know, God provides those opportunities for change and those skills. So.
Thank you. I was listening intently, and thank you, Mayor, for your hearty sharing. I picked up some keywords, and those keywords were good highlights as answers to the question, how Christian faith impacts life, purpose, calling, serving. You referred to, for example, empathy, serving, sacrifice. You know, sometimes a little bit of a suffering and painstaking, and you reached out. All this actually were just living examples of how that impacts you.
Right.
Thank you. A little bit more sure before we move to
sure. So I really value this opportunity right now as a community member to go out and spend time, whether it's through organizations like yourselves here, faith-based organizations, or education or cultural organizations. We have an incredibly diverse community, and unfortunately right now, one of the challenges I see, not just for the church or for organizations, is how can we come together as people and be able to have respectful dialogue and be able to understand difference from people's point of views. I was laughing or not laughing, I saw somebody recently, we had put them on a role of commission, and I saw a fellow Christian wrote to them and said, don't forget, God gave you 2 years and only one mouth. So listen more. And it's hard when you go out there. I mean, you learn a lot more humility when you go out and spend time with people, but you also learn that there's the opportunity. I really treasure and value the opportunity to be able to be part of looking at succession planning. When I was in management, I always was looking at people who are flexible and able to deal with change. And selfishly now, as a parent and as a community member, I'm trying to be able to understand that type of change, whether it's in the business world, in the community, in infrastructure, to have that global vision to figure out how can I change and adapt or learn about needs. An example right now for me that I would say in my community is homelessness and mental health. And we're seeing that throughout the entire Bay Area. And how can we help? And so I've reached out to different organizations. I've been meeting with hospitals to look at how can we expand mental health services, locations of that. I've been talking to faith-based groups. It's not just about serving food, but about some of the longer-term needs. I've thought about it when it comes to my police force and the planning and trying to build some triage between Alameda County Behavioral Health and when we go out to look at the service for the community. Even things like that you wouldn't think are related, like in the summer, I had thought more about some of our plants and growth, overgrowth, because this year was a wet season, and there's a lot of trees and plants, and I was worried about brush fires, especially when homeless, you know, you don't think about when you're cold, you go inside, you turn on your heater, but for some people, they light a fire, and they don't realize that they have to, either because of mental health or because they didn't learn Girl Scouts or Boy Scouts, they didn't learn how to put out the ashes, and we've had a couple fires. And so I had as much as possible the brush cut back, so that way, you know, away from people's houses, you know, trying to anticipate all these issues. And so the more I learn, it's often by going out to events in the community, Coffee with the Cops, National Night Out, and it's very different. It's not that I don't value my staff for giving me reports, but I always tell people, you hear very different things when you go and talk to the people who live it every day in the community. So I really enjoy that, whether it's the walkthrough for businesses, talking to the schools. It's a very different perspective when you hear from the community themselves. And so thank you for giving me this opportunity to listen to some of these concerns today.
Thank you. Well, you also referred to engaging at the front. And also one final comment before we move to Elder Jimmy. I admire Mayor Lady's gift in naturally sharing her faith in a very natural way. Right? This takes gift, practice, courage. So I also encourage all of you in the marketplace, right? Let people know your faith. Let people know how he plays a role in your life in a very natural way. And this is one way to best be the testimony, right? Okay, so Elder Jimmy, would you share a little bit of the role of the faith?
Sure. 我想那个 faith 跟我们的 life 是不能够分开的 所以对我来讲 我想从三方面 来看 第一个就是 我们的identity 因为我们常常不知不觉的 把这个我们的 faith 把我们的 life 给compartment compartmentalized 就是说我现在是工作的生活我是家庭的生活我是教会的生活我现在是 it's time for myself my leisure time 所以我们会把它 放成不同的 silos 然后常常不知不觉的就 戴不同的帽子穿不同的衣服 不同的 behavior 在这个不同的这个领域里面 生活领域里面 我也很谢谢 Mayor的分享 她是很 naturally 因为她知道 who she is I think we know who we are you know who you are is so important so identity means first to me 我是 a child of God 我是一个基督徒 我是被神所爱的 我是有一个新的生命是 born by the spirit 我是一个有一个新的属灵的生命在我们这些是一些对我来讲是一个很自然很基本的一个信念那有这样的一个认知的话那就帮助我们在不同的生活领域你知道你是谁那个蛮重要的譬如说 我就举一个例子 我们的生活常常我们在 seek significance right? 我们在这就是说我到底是谁我的尤其中国人我的面子这些事情那但你要知道你是谁你知道我知道我是谁我知道 我的 significance the rooted in Christ 神爱我爱到一个地步他 把他的儿子赐给我 来救那这样子一些很清楚的一些自我的认知的话会帮助我们在一些碰到一些挫折或一些事情的话有不同的 attitude 去面对那我觉得第一个就是对我来讲是我常常也一方面也祷告也提醒我自己是是一个基督徒不管是在什么样的生活层面所以在公司里面我很自然的会我很少去跟人家什么直接传福音什么都没有但是我想从生活里头从言谈里头或从 first of all, I have to say, 我有很多的毛病跟问题啊，绝对不是 perfect 啊。但是我觉得这些 you know, a clear identity of who I am as a Christian 啊，帮助我能够在一些啊行事为人，甚至是在一些啊思想的一些啊层面都能够啊。知道怎么样去行事为人。我想举一个例子好了，我这样比较清楚，因为还要讲的比较抽象。我们在大概这是2014年底了，已经快三年了。我们公司原来是一个 NASDAQ 上市的公司，那那你知道这个在 public 公司最怕碰到的就是。activist shareholder， 我们公司就被一个很大的一个很凶悍的一个 active shareholder 给找到了，然后不是找到，给 lock 住，然后找我们麻烦，要换掉我们的这个董事，因为说我们公司可以更好，那个时候公司已经蛮好了，我们 it's profitable for several years， not even you know lost。money in a single quarter， 但是我们因为 invest 一些 new technology new market， 所以他认为说我们 it's not profitable enough， 我们没有注重到 shareholder value， all kind of attack essentially， and I want to replace our board， 那我们公司就board 要我去become the chief negotiator with them。Want to find a settlement， 那这个是 kind of mission impossible， 因为他们的原来的就是要把我们公司要 take control， 然后 divide up， 然后怎么样能够让股票能够更好，然后 short term 一些 return， right？ They are really good at， 而且这个 track record 是 85% successful rate， really professional。比我们大的公司都是到最后都是被他们 manipulate in a way。那我有这样子一个责任，马上我就觉得是重担在身，因为我第一个我也是一个不是很善言辞的人不是说我 you know I'm not very eloquent， I'm not a really good negotiator engineering background, you know, English is not even my native language, right? 那员工呢？那我们公司已经二十几年了，员工就是说，Jimmy 全靠你了，那我又想，要是我被，然后我们就这么失败了，然后就被人家 replace 扫地出门。不但是可惜，对不对？我是co-founder， 那好像也丢脸嘛 ，right？ 到最后你是被人家赶出门 ，right？ 大的不得了那个压力。那你想那样患得患失的心理的话，很难去 really know what to do，right？ I really didn't know what to do， 但是后来我观念就改过来了。为什么改过来了呢？第一个，我就马上就有一个神的一个给我一个意念，就说 "You know who you are." You know who you are. 我就想 ，Yeah, I know who I am. 我的面子有这么重要吗？假使有神的儿子，都神把他的儿子都赐给我，为我死在十字架上，这样子爱我，有这样子创造天地万物的主，有这样子对我的肯定，难道我还？在乎面子赢跟输吗 ？Right？ 那第二个，我就想到，像哥罗西书第三章讲的说 ，It is Christ you serve。在我们工作里面，我们常常有这种 compartmentalized life， 就是我在教会才是不是神，但是没有在圣经里面看不到，在新约里面看不到有 division of 所谓的 secular and sacred， right？ 而是说你是谁，而不是说你做什么事。就让你变成一个属神的人，不是你在教会查经就变成一个属神的人，你在社会上做事就是一个属事的人，不是这样子，而是你是一个属神的人，神把你放在社会上面， 做事。所以有这样的观念，我想，it's the Lord I'm serving. So ultimate boss is He. Why I worry about? 那他也是很随时跟我同在，能够帮助我，能够给我wisdom， 然后I have someone I can really depend on and look up to. 最后的 result 呢 ，I surrender to Him. 最后说这些很自然的这些观念，我一下心就平静了。心平静了，就脑筋就清楚了，因为你不会患得患失了。那你就可以去在谈判桌上面去那，因为他也很难激怒你，因为他也你也很难被 intimidate， 你也很能够很谦卑的，因为你知道你本来就不行，你本来就不是对手，也没什么可以骄傲的，完全。所以这样子一个平，我讲一个平常心啊，帮助我在这个整个 process， 当时一个 very difficult process， we negotiate for 3 months， going kind of in circles， 啊、right? 所以每次讲什么威胁什么，我就we hear you， thank you for sharing your perspective， match your mind， 啊、然后什么的，然后就I'll take this input。back to the board and we'll discuss and get back to you. 然后反正就是 anyway 我们可以有一些，然后我常常提醒他们这个 we have a common goal. You want stock price to go up and the company do well. We do too. Right? We have a common goal. 所以我们必须要attack each other. 什么这些东西能够帮助我能够去看事情 from different angles， 所以我想我说的就是 faith has anything everything to do with our work。
谢谢 Jimmy 的分享哈，这个他引用的克罗西书说，我们所侍奉的是主基督啊。当然我们 of course we report to you report to your supervisor in the marketplace。You report to your board， 但是 ultimately 是侍奉的是主，那是一个很好的 sobering reminder。So in about 2 minutes 呢 ，so we've come to the last question， about 3 minutes for each of you， 一个 important question 就是呢 ，words of encouragement advice to aspiring women leaders or Christians in expanding leadership。那这是 to Mayor， to Jimmy 的话，就是 aspiring the Chinese American the leaders， 以及很简单的就是给他一点鼓励。Now I will tell my story in about 1 minute。很多年前，中国政府有 organize 这个一个正式的 government 的 sponsor invited 的technology and industry consortium。I had the honor to lead consortium。那是中国政府的上宾，那我们最后做完一些重要的策略报告之后，到这个人民大会堂做正式的官方报告。那深受很大的感动，所以我希望能够来祝福这个说我们很努力在最后正式官方报告结束，就是中国所有的官员在这边，那么在国宴报告像我考虑很久，打算很久，我最后的 very last was God bless China， 我考虑很久，我决定用英文来讲，免得让安排我的这些国务院官员呢、啊，是因为这是高规格的。那我准备结束之后，我准备看看有没有人表达关怀。所以 actually 不但没有啊，他们也都非常的高兴，很谢谢我们对他们的帮助。那事实上这些包括对他们的国家主席跟总理有很大的意思，因为我们知道他们也直接看到这些建议书。那事实上因为那一次呢，就我才知道我自己的 delegation 150 people。当中有许多的 Christian， 但是因为是在中国，大家都 try to be discreet， there's nothing wrong to be discreet。可是我没有想到我的这样一个 encouragement 呢， is like a call to all the brothers sisters。我才知道哦，原来有这么多这样的朋友当中。后来呢，我们就说 we should gather， 那可是没有地方，那我就请中国政府帮我安排一个 big conference room。我说 we need about 3 hours， don't come in。所以我们就在他们为我们安排的 facility， we pray the worship。
然后 share 有个 great fellowship， 都是 arranged by the Chinese government。Okay， so 我想 it definitely impacts the way we serve the family from the perspective。All right， so last one， 有没有什么 words of encouragement advice to women aspiring leaders？
Well, I think that one thing that when I was growing up, and I see that in industry too, there's not sometimes a lot of women leaders.Part of it is, I don't know, God gave me some great blessings and challenges. Every time I got pregnant, I also got promoted. I used to tell people, 3 more babies and I'm CEO. you know, it just timing-wise sometimes it wasn't very easy. But it also gave me a lot more empathy. And so it allows me to adapt and think about ways to encourage. I had a fellow woman in my group that was pregnant the same time as me. And when I was pregnant, I had gestational diabetes. And just, you know, how we lead or how we become creative. And I think women are very creative in addressing their lives every day. And so for me, when I had the meeting, I knew she was also pregnant. I'm like, let's go for a walk. We're going to get a smoothie and split it in half and be healthy. And we're going to walk as we do our meeting, because we both need to keep healthy for the babies. And so, you know, how we adapt and also to help one another. Unfortunately, having worked in industry a lot of times too, also, it seems that unfortunately, women aren't always supportive of each other as they could be. And it's either competitive or other things. And I think it's really important to help mentor the next generation and to provide that hand and outreach. I feel so lucky that when I was younger and I was in high school, I had some great mentors and people who gave me good advice, and they really cared about me as a person and in my career. And now that as I am an adult, I've been able to do the same for others. And that's the only thing I ask for from the young women that I mentor, is that if you feel that I helped you, I don't need you to pay me back or anything. I just need you to consider that when you're in that opportunity, you do the same for others. And that's not just something that I'd say advice for women. It'd be advice for anybody.
Yes.
But in particular, it does help a lot for, I think, I'm surprised when we talk about faith, and I think I shared this story with you too, that I am out in our community a lot, and besides Christians, we have temples, mosques, gurdwaras, and one of the challenges for me before when I was on the school board, I go to a lot of Muslim events too, and in the past sometimes, you know, traditionally they separate for worship. They have the men on one side and the women on the other, and I always think about when I go there to dress respectfully. I usually wear pants, and I always have a headscarf ready when I go to worship. But when I was running, one thing that I don't think about when I became the mayor is that in the past, I always sit on one side and things are passed back to me. But they've always had the mayor go up to the front and get awards or do a little speech and welcome people. And it became a question a little bit when I became the woman mayor. Do we let her go up or not? What do we do? You know? And so for me, I was invited to go up for some events in this past year. And I've had a lot of young women come up to me and said, you know, it means so much to me for me to see you up there, because I don't see a lot of women leaders up there. And so it was really exciting for them to see that. And so you are, in effect, sometimes making change without you even knowing about it. And so it's harder to compartmentalize my life by telling people. I feel like sometimes I live in a fishbowl. Because like I've even been in the grocery store buying milk, and someone's like, I need to tell you about the road. And you're like, okay, no. And so I'm sitting there going, okay, and my children are like, oh, no. You know, and they're used to this by now. But you know, it is sometimes harder to compartmentalize. And my son used to tease me. He goes, don't yell, because I might videotape you and put you on YouTube. And so it's funny how you handle this. And so it's with grace and humor. And I always think back, one of my favorite Bible verses, I can do all things through him who gives me strength.
Amen.
And truly at times, I can be totally honest, you know, when I'm campaigning or with just life in general, there's days where I just feel like a little crazy. And you're so tired. But then I really feel very blessed that God gives me that opportunity. Even like when I was campaigning, I was telling people, one of my friends invited me to this music worship. And there was a girls choir singing in the beginning, and they were singing, Are You Weary? And I was going to say, yes, I am. And they're like, okay, it's not interactive. Don't respond. but so having that type of humor, I think, is important. And, you know, God willing, I will continue to serve whatever roles. It's interesting, even as right now as the mayor, people say, what do you want to do next? And I've just been in office for 9 months. And I want to, we talk about people who are your heroes, and one of my favorite heroes is Benjamin Franklin, because he was the person who made a difference in history and in life. And it wasn't about just, you know, a politician thinks about his next election. A statesman thinks about his people. And it's about thinking about what you can do to make lives better rather than what you can do to make your life better. So.
Thank you. Thank you for sharing the reminder, caring and supporting, and coaching forward, and be that this precious, holistic, shining example in the fishbowl. Thank you. So maybe a few words from Elder Jing, and we can close up.
我想对加子你已经是基督徒了，我希望你能够真的是了解你是多么有福气的人，有这个神爱你，有圣灵在你的生命里面，你有 much more resource than you probably ever realized. 所以 just be grateful and be the person that God made you to be. 因为我们很多的 potential 神已经给了我，那我是真是鼓励弟兄姐妹对神的话里面能够多明了一些，不是只在字面，能够思想跟你的生活有什么样的关系。我觉得这是一个像一个金矿，一个 gold mine, you already put in the gold mine, utilize it, right, and enjoy it. 那假使你还没有信主的话，这是一个非常好的 forum， 不但能够认识一些跟你一样在工作里面的一些同事、朋友，那他们有的，我们盼望你在经过这样子的一些不管座谈也好、小组里面、个人的谈话里面或教会里面的聚会里面，希望能够有机会能够认识这位 wonderful God。
谢谢 Jimmy 长老。那我想我们请my partner Sam 在也许做一个结束的祝福的祷告，来祝福这个 Mayor，祝福Elder Jimmy， 然后再好，请大家一起起立做祷告。你可以中文、英文都可以。OK，好。 天天父，主耶稣，主啊，谢谢你，像刚才我们弟兄所分享的，主啊，你呼召我们来做你的儿女，这是何等大的一个荣耀，主耶稣也谢谢你把我们每一个人放在我们生命中、生活中、社会中、社区中的不同的 position， 主耶稣，我相信主啊， where we are today， you have a purpose for us， and you have built us up for that purpose。 我们这一生 up to this point， 我们所有的 experience， 你所有给我们那些属天的 gifting， is all for where we are today。 So Lord， I pray， 主啊，让我们在 we don't just focus on future and where we want to be， but where we are today， 让我们真是每天都可以来顺从圣灵的带领，在我们现有的岗位上可以来为你做盐做光。主耶稣，我也这边特别求你来祝福。 Mayor Lily， 还有 Elder Jimmy， 主啊，在他们忙碌的工作和他们在教会的服事，主耶稣就求你那个属天的那个 grace and wisdom to be upon them， 让他们一切所做的，主啊，都充满了你的智慧和 blessing。 感谢赞美你，以上祈求都奉我主耶稣的名求， Amen。 谢谢，请大家请坐。 Quick, I guess shameless plug. 那大家都是 aspiring leaders, right? 像刚刚讲，大家在我们所在的岗位上都可以 practice leadership. 那我们的 leadership circle, 基本上是在帮助大家可以真正的 become leaders in your own domain. 那我们在做什么？
那我们首先第一个is very important to be as leaders， 就是我们有一个 lifetime 的 self improvement continuous learning 的一个 habit。We will help you build that. Okay. 那当然for any role, right? We don't stop at just head knowledge. 我们一定要把我们所学的可以 apply, 可以 demonstrate. 所以说我们会 work with everybody, 然后让大家有机会可以 actually work on leadership project to really practice leadership. 那第三个的话其实是that's why we're all here, right? To have mentors, to have coaches. 那我知道很多的华人在这个mentorship 和 leadership is lacking a lot, right? Some of us don't see the need or don't understand the need, 或者说 is afraid to go out and, you know, reach out and get a mentor. 那我们今天可以看到我们这边有很多很棒的 mentor, so 在 AdCloud 的这个 facility, right, 可以给大家有这个 mentorship 的这个 access. 那最后一点 again, least notLast but not least, 我们 as a leader, 我们跟神的连接是 critical, it's very important, right? 因为我们所有的gifting, 我们所有的 inspiration, right? 我们应当做什么，不应当做什么，神都会来带领我们。所以说 all of the above, 我们在这个 leadership circle 都会跟大家一起 discuss, 然后一起 work on. 所以说等一下我们结束以后可以留下的 mentor 们会在这边welcome for Q&A。 那我们下一季的 sign up 还没有开始，那通常leadership circle gets filled out pretty quickly。 那如果 if you guys are interested for next term feel free to talk to Jerry and I 我们可以把你放在那个 pre-register priority 的上。 OK 好 alright 再一次谢谢我们今天的 panel speaker。
今天谢谢两位，如果我们手中两个 God bless you。
God bless you. 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 God bless